After reading, enriching, and cleaning text data, the next step is transformation. In this video, we'll take a look at two data transformation steps, creating a bag of words and calculating document frequencies. We'll need these transformations to be able to create document vectors as features of a machine learning model. So, what is a bag of words? A bag of words represents each document with a list of words within it. As an example, let's build the bag of words of two documents, in this case, restaurant reviews. One, friendly neighborhood, great staff, great food, reasonably priced. Two, friendly Italian restaurant, great Italian wine list, and Italian grappa selections. The bag of words of the first document would have the words friendly, neighborhood, great, staff, food, reasonably, and priced. Here you see the bag of words for the second document. Friendly, Italian, restaurant, great, wine, list, and grappa, and selections. In KNIME Analytics platform, we can create a bag of words with the bag of words creator node. Let's try it for a list of restaurant reviews that we've pre-processed already. In the configuration window, in this drop-down menu, we select the document column based on which we want to create the bag of words. The node produces the bag of words in a column of type term, and we can change the output column name here in this field. In this include-exclude framework, we can select which input columns we want to keep in the output table. Let's execute the node and take a look at the output. The output table is a collection of document and term tuples. The term column shows the bag of words of each document in the document corpus. If we wanted to continue with a string representation of the bag of words, we could use the term to string node. The next step is to calculate frequencies based on the bag of words. The frequencies tell us which words are descriptive of the content of a single document, or respectively, the entire corpus. You can find the nodes for calculating different types of frequencies in the frequencies subcategory in the node repository. Here, we'll take a look at the TF, DF, and IDF nodes. All three nodes have a similar configuration dialog. In the first tab, we select the document column for calculating the frequencies. In the second tab, we define the type of the frequency measure more specifically. The input table must include two columns, a document column and its bag of words in a term column. The TF node calculates the absolute and relative term frequencies within the documents. Absolute frequency is the count of a term in a document. For example, the absolute frequency of the word great is 2 in the first document and 1 in the second document. The absolute frequency works well if the document corpus only contains documents of similar length, for example, tweets. Relative frequency normalizes the absolute frequency by the total number of terms in the document. The first document has 8 words in total, and the second document has 11 words. Therefore, the word friendly that appears in both has a greater relative frequency in the first document because it has fewer words in total. In general, the relative frequency is needed when we compare documents of different length. The DF node calculates the document frequency as the number of documents in the corpus that contain each term. In our mini corpus of two documents, the words great and friendly occur in both documents, and their document frequency is 2. The other words occur in only one document, and thus their document frequency is 1. The IDF node calculates the inverse document frequency. It measures how common or rare a term is across all documents. It's the logarithm of the inverse relationship of the number of documents containing the term and the number of documents in the document corpus. In our example, the IDF score is 0 for all words that occur in both documents and 0.3 for all words that occur in only one. The IDF has 3 variations: normalized, smooth, and probabilistic. Smooth IDF is selected by default in the IDF node, since it avoids 0 scores for terms that occur in all documents in the corpus. A common practice is to multiply the IDF and TF scores into one metric called TF-IDF. The TF part accounts for words that are frequent within a document, and the IDF part accounts for words that uniquely identify a document. Words that occur frequently within but rarely across documents, such as Italian, have higher TF-IDF scores than words that occur rarely within a document, such as grappa, or frequently across documents, such as great. In this video, we've shown how to transform a document into a bag of words representation and how to convert term cells into string cells. We've also introduced different types of frequencies, explained what they measure, and shown how to calculate them in KNIME. These transformation steps are needed for building a document vector and eventually training a machine learning model on our text data.